Hi everyone, good morning. I hope all of you are good and I am also fine. So today I will take class from physics and from class 11. The chapter is vector or motion in a plane. Okay, so let's start. Vector. That is motion in a plane. Okay, right. So first we have to know what is vector. All of you know this. Know that one. What is vector? That is vector quantity. Okay, in the lower class. So a vector means a physical quantity. A physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction. Okay, called vector quantity. Example, force. Example, displacement, acceleration and velocity, etc. Velocity and so many, torque, you can say torque also, etc. Okay, so what is vector? A vector is a physical quantity which has both magnitude and directions. Okay, the example is force. Force has a direction and as well as its magnitude. Suppose I applied force on the board in the directions. Okay, like the magnitude of the force is 50 newton and direction is towards the board. Okay, so force has the both magnitude and direction. Now how can you represent a vector? Representation of vector. Okay, now representation of a vector. So in Cartesian coordinate, Cartesian means xyz coordinate. Okay, Cartesian means xyz coordinate. We can represent a vector is like that. Suppose this one is a vector. Okay, so a vector is, and this point is p, this one is x, y and z. The coordinate of the point is xyz. So how can represent this vector? A vector equal to, suppose this one is origin, x I cap y j cap plus z k cap. So what are I cap, j cap, k cap here, sir? So I cap, j cap, k cap are unit vectors along x, y and z axis respectively. Okay, fine. So these are the unit vectors. That means they define or they identify or denote the direction of their respective axis. That is, the direction of axis is we can get by I cap, and direction of y axis we can get by j cap, and direction of z axis we can get by k cap. Okay, so this is the representation of vector. Now types of vectors. What are the different types of vectors are there? So many vectors are there. There are near about 9 to 10 vectors are there, types. But I just discussed here just important terms here. Okay, important types here I will discuss here. So now first one is unit vector. Okay, unit vector. A vector whose magnitude is 1. Okay, whose magnitude is 1 is called unit vector, right? So if A is a vector, then we can say mod of A is what? 1. Suppose I consider A vector is like that. A vector is xi yj plus zk, right? Now modulus of A will be
एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर प्लस जेड स्क्वायर नाउ यूनिट वेक्टर ऑफ ए विल बी यूनिट वेक्टर ऑफ ए विल बी ए कैफ इक्वल टू ए वेक्टर बाय मोड ऑफ ए
ओके व्हेन वी डिवाइड ए वेक्टर विथ इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड विल गेट द यूनिट वेक्टर ऑफ द of that vector okay so take a screenshot from that now
number two types of vector okay types of vector I write here so number two types is position vector so position vector is what suppose this one is x this one is y this one is z and p is here is point 1 point p x1 y1 z1 and here is another point x2 y2 z2 okay suppose this one is origin o suppose one particle initially at point p and finally it travels in this way okay home here to here so position vector always calculate with respect to origin you have to remember this one position vector always measure with respect to I write here position vectors always measure or determine with respect to with respect to origin okay just short note for understand I give a short note over here so now their position vector of p will be now position vector of p is point p is op which is those it will be the position vector of p will be op and position vector of q will be oq right op is the position vector of p and oq is the position vector of q it will be x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap right and it will be position vector again position vector of point q is oq equal to x to y y to j z to k okay now we can find from that displacement vector and another type is displacement vector okay so displacement vector this is the displacement vector the displacement vector pq is displacement vector okay here pq is displacement vector so pq equal how much position vector of q minus position vector of p that is position vector of final position minus position vector of initial position right so it will be x to y y to j plus z to k here x1 I cap minus y1 j cap minus z1 k cap right so take common I cap here so it will be x1 minus x2 I cap it will be y2 minus y1 j cap and it will be plus z2 minus z1 k cap so position vector will be this one so position vector will be pq that is position vector of, sorry displacement vector will be pq that is position vector of q minus position vector of p okay this vector has huge application in the numerical section okay so you have to remember this one now the type 4 is zero vector so what is zero vector a vector whose magnitude is zero a vector whose magnitude is 0. R cross 0 vector, that is if A is a 0 vector, then we can say mod A equal to 0. Okay. Now, properties of 0 vectors. Some properties is there. Properties of 0 0 vector, n is known. O is there. 0 vector is denoted by O. That's why I am written here O, okay, instead of N. Properties of 0 vector is A vector plus 0 vector equal to A vector, and 0 vector lambda into 0 vector equal to 0 vector, 0 into 0 vector equal to 0 vector. Okay, so these are the properties of 0 vectors. A vector plus 0 vector equal to A vector, and 0 vector lambda into lambda is an integer. If I multiply with 0 vector, it will be 0 vector, and if I multiply 0 with A, any vector which is not 0, non-zero vector, then it will become 0 vector. Okay, so these are the basic formulas. So now we will study another type of vectors, another type, that is 6 types, that is collinear vector. Okay, collinear vectors. Collinear vector is what, sir? When two or more vectors, two or more vectors lies in the same straight line. Okay, same straight line, lies in the same straight line, or parallel to each other, or parallel to each other, called collinear vectors. Okay, collinear vectors. For example, let me give you one example here. Suppose this one is one line, and this is A vector and this is vector. So here A vector and B vector are collinear. Okay, suppose this one is one vector A and this one is another vector B, they are parallel. Here A vector or B vector are also collinear, right? Okay, so how can you write mathematically? So mathematically I can express, or we can express the collinearity, this A vector is equal to lambda B vector. This is the condition for collinearity. Mathematically we can express is ET. Okay, so where lambda is any integer, if A vector is equal to lambda B vector, then A is, A comma B are collinear, A comma B are collinear vectors. Understood this much? Okay, if A vector equal to lambda B vector, then we can say A or B are collinear, where lambda is any integer, right? Next, the last one. The last one is, there are so many vectors, coterminous vector, co-initial vectors, free vectors, equal vectors, I don't group this one. I just give the all the important formulas and important parts of the vectors. Okay, next one is coplanar vectors. What is coplanar vectors? When three or more vectors lies in the same straight line, in the same plane, called coplanar vector. Okay, so let me give you one example. Suppose this one is x, this one is y, and this one is z, and there is one vector A and there is another vector B and there is another vector suppose C. So this one is x1 xy plane, is not it? This one is xy plane, this one is zx plane and this one is yz plane, is not it?
So look at here, A vector, B vector and C vector are all the three lies in the same plane, there is xy plane. So we can say A vector, B vector and C vector are coplanar.
So here A vector, B vector, C vector are coplanar, that is they remain in the same plane.
If A will he is here and B and C is here, then we can't say A, B, C are coplanar. Okay, so mathematically
we can say AB coplanar if A dot B cross C equal to 0. If A dot B cross C equal to 0, then A comma B comma C vector are coplanar.
Understood? All of you understood this one? That is, if A vector, B vector, A dot B cross C is 0, then we can say A, B, C are coplanar. What is dot and what is cross product? I will discuss in the next class. Okay, next class I will discuss. So take a screenshot from that. I hope this is helpful for you. So thank you for watching. Bye bye.